poem for like a month now. So to all my writers in the building, procrastination kills.
Amen. Amen.
In the building, let's get it. No. Teachers don't know. Mr. Smith don't know. Mrs. Harris don't know. And Mrs. Ryan don't know. Just teachers don't know. Mrs. Harris gave Arnold the detention for being late to school, but she don't know that he has to walk 2 miles to school. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he can get on the bus, but he gave his bus tickets to his mom, whose car got repossessed. Mm-hmm. Arnold tells Mrs. Harris that he has to walk 2 miles, but Mrs. Harris has the nerve to say, that's not my problem. But you told your so-called students that you would help us any way you could. Teachers don't know. Mr. Smith writes Lisa up for having her hood on in class, and at the end of class, Lisa tells Mr. Smith she has cancer and is causing her to lose her hair. But Mr. Smith doesn't apologize for writing Lisa up because he says you have to follow the rules. Teachers don't know. You teach us about numbers, you teach us about words, but we can teach you about struggle and we can teach you about hurt. High school is not like how it was for you teachers. I'm not saying that all teachers are bad, but some of them hate their jobs. And they treat us students like we're slobs and think we're never going to have any jobs. Teachers don't know. In the teacher's lounge, you gossip about how a student named Tim got into a fight and you call him a violent person and you say that he needs help when all he was trying to do was defend someone who couldn't. Teachers don't know. In science, we learn about birds, but we never learn why they fly, and it make me think, is everything I'm being taught a lie? Am I ever going to need this stuff in life? Can I get more information in a newspaper than in a 40-minute class where we talk about the history of the Civil Rights Movement just because it's February? Teachers don't know. Mr. Hennig took Gerald's phone, and Gerald tells him that his father is in the hospital because of a heart attack, and he has to stay posted with his mom, but Mr. Smith says, you can do that after class. I mean, like, really, what's the problem? When students have these type of issues, do you not care? Do you think that all we are worried about is our face and our hair? We have families, just like you. We have lives, just like you. And we have problems, just like you. But I guess this is your class. We have to follow your rules. Rules that don't even make sense. Like, if you're late to my class, you're not allowed in my class. But my class before yours is on the other side of the school, so what you expect me to do? Run to your class? No, I'll get a detention, because the rule is no running in the hall, so I guess I have to find another alternative. But hey, that's not your problem. Teachers don't know. High school is like the army. The principal is the commander, and assistant principals are the generals. The teachers are the drill sergeants, and the students are the soldiers. And in the classroom, is where there is the training camp, where the information we learn in the training camp will prepare us for the battlefield, also known as the real world. And the ones that don't make it in the training camp get discharged, or in other words, they don't graduate. But for the ones in the classroom that act like they don't want to be there, but they're always in the classroom, they are always disrupting class, but they are always in school. They have to want something. They must want to be something. They must want to see themselves on the battlefield. It just takes the right person and the right teacher to lead that soldier in the right direction and to look at that soldier's problem from their point of view. For the teachers that know this and know the true meaning of being a teacher and give students reasons for coming back to school, and you can relate to your students in the best way possible, God bless you. But for the teachers that don't, that's not my problem.